To get regular updates, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon. Hello friends, this is Manohar Veera from Exambin. In this lesson, we are going to see about Buddhism, a religion born out of India over 2500 years ago, and it's practiced around the world today. Before getting into the video, please subscribe to Exambin channel to get continuous updates about our new videos right from your mobile or desktop. So let's look on the today's session now. Gautama Buddha founded Buddhism and is known as Supreme Buddha. He was born in Lumbini, a little principality of Kapilavastu in modern-day Nepal. Buddhahood or Buddhatva is the state of perfect enlightenment attained by a Buddha. This refers to the universal and innate property of absolute wisdom. Symbols of five great events of Buddha's life are 1. Buddha's birth, lotus and bull. 2. The great departure, horse. 3. Enlightenment, Bodhi tree. 4. First Samman, that is a wheel. 5. Death, that's Stupa. The Four Noble Truths. Four Noble Truths were taught by Buddha in Dhammachakraparivartan. They are the core teachings of Buddhism. 1. Sorrow. The world is full of sorrow, and everything from birth to death brings sorrows in life. Cause of sorrow. The cause of sorrows is desire. It is the unfulfillment of human desires which leads him to vicious cycle of births and rebirths. Prevention of sorrow. It is possible to prevent sorrow. Man can get rid of sorrow by triumphing over the desires. The path of prevention of sorrow. Man can avoid sorrow by avoiding extremes of life and following middle path or madhyam patipada, the life of moderation and self-control, along with pursuance of eightfold path, is essential to prevent the sorrow. So what are the eightfold paths? They're also called the middle path, and is the system of following these eight divisions of the path to achieve spiritual enlightenment and cease suffering. Number 1. Right understanding. Understanding that the Four Noble Truths are noble and true. 2. Right thought. Determining and resolving to practice Buddhist faith. Number 3. Right speech. Avoiding slander, gossips, lying, and all forms of untrue and abusive speech. Number 4. Right conduct. Adhering to the idea of non-violence, as well as refraining from any form of stealing or sexual impropriety. Number 5. Right means of making a living. Not slaughtering animals or working at jobs that force you to violate others. Number 6. Right mental attitude or effort. Avoiding negative thoughts and emotions such as anger and jealousy. Number 7. Right mindfulness. Having a clear sense of one's mental state and bodily health and feelings. And number 8. Right concentration. Using meditation to reach the highest level of enlightenment. From the initial days, Buddhist literature has grown. We're going to see some of the Buddhist literature books now. 1. Tripitaka. Tripitaka, or Three Baskets, is a traditional term used for various Buddhist scriptures. It is known as Pali Canon in English. The three Pitakas are Sutta Pitaka, Vinaya Pitaka, and Abhidhamma Pitaka. Sutta Pitaka. It contains over 10,000 sutras and suttas related to Buddha and his close companions. This also deals with the first Buddhist council, which was held shortly after Buddha's death, dated by a majority of recent scholars around 400 BC. Under the patronage of King Ajatasattu, with the monk Mahakashyapa presiding at Rajgir. Vinaya Pitaka. The subject matter of Vinaya Pitaka is the monastic rules for monks and nuns. It can also be called as Book of Discipline. Abhidhamma Pitaka. It deals with the philosophy and doctrine of Buddhism appearing in the suttas. However, it does not contain the systematic philosophical treatises. There are 7 works of Abhidhamma Pitaka, which most scholars agree that don't represent the words of Buddha himself. Some terminologies associated with Buddhism are Nirvana. The concept of Nirvana in Buddhism is entirely different from the Hinduism. Buddhism denies the concept of moksha. However, it defines Nirvana as to be getting rid of cycle of death and birth. It is achieved in the lifetime itself and not after death. To achieve Nirvana, one should follow moral code of conduct. Jatakas. Jatakas are very much close to folklore literature and they contain the tales of previous births of Buddha in poems. The Jataka have also been mentioned in Kodaka Nikaya. There are 547 poems. Buddha Charita. Buddha Charita is an epic style Sanskrit work by Ashvaghosha and was compiled in 2nd century BC. Dharmaraksha, who is known to have translated many works of Buddhism in Chinese, translated this work in Chinese in 420 AD. It mainly deals with Buddha's life. Ashvaghosha also wrote a Sanskrit drama, Shariputra Prakaran, which deals about Sariputta or Sariputra, the disciple of Buddha. Bodhivamsa. Bodhivamsa is a mixed Sanskrit Pali text which was composed by Upatisha under the rule of Mahinda IV of Sri Lanka in 10th century AD. It describes the arrival of branch of Bodhi tree in Sri Lanka and many other things which mentioned in Mahavamsa. Now we're going to see about the types of Buddhisms existing now or in the ancient India. Number 1. Hinayana. Hinayana is the orthodox, conservative schools of Buddhism. Don't believe in idol worship and try to attain individual salvation through self-discipline and meditation. Ashoka patronized Hinayana. Pali is the language used by Moses for Hinayana scholars. It is a dominant form of religion in Cambodia, Laos, Sri Lanka, Thailand and Burma. Mahayana. Mahayana Buddhism, also known as the Great Vehicle, is a form of Buddhism prominent in North Asia including China, Mongolia, Tibet, Korea and Japan. This section believes in the heavenliness of Buddha and believes in idol worship. Fundamental principles of Mahayana doctrine were based on the possibility of universal liberation from suffering from all beings, hence the Great Vehicle and the existence of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas embodying Buddha nature. It allows salvation to be alternatively obtained through the grace of Amitabha Buddha. By having faith and devoting oneself to mindfulness of the Buddha, this section believes in mantras. The main Mahayana sections include Pure Land, Zen and Vajrayana or Tantric Buddhism. Vajrayana Buddhism. The Vajrayana tradition of Buddhism spread to China, Mongolia and Tibet. Vajrayana Buddhists recognize a large body of Buddhist tantras, some of which are also included in Chinese and Japanese collections of Buddhist literature and versions of a few even in Pali canon. Zen Buddhism. Zen Buddhism, pronounced Chan in Chinese, Xion in Korean, as Zen in Japanese, derived from the Sanskrit term Dhyana, meaning meditation, is a form of Buddhism that became popular in China, Korea and Japan and that lays special emphasis on meditation. Zen places less emphasis on scriptures than some other forms of Buddhism and prefers to focus on direct spiritual breakthroughs to truth. Zen Buddhist teachings is often full of paradox. In order to loosen the grip of the ego, to facilitate the penetration into the realm of the true self or formless self, which is equated with the Buddha himself. Bodhisattva. A bodhisattva means one has essence of enlightenment. Anyone who has a spontaneous wish to attain Buddhahood for the benefit of all is bodhisattva. It is very popular subject in Buddhist art. A bodhisattva is bound to enlightenment and refers to all who are destined to become Buddhas in this life or another life. There are celestial bodhisattvas which are manifestations of Gautama Buddha. Buddhist shrines. Ashtamahasthanas. There are 8 great holy places. They are follows. 1. Lumbini, that is birth of Buddha. 2. Bodhgaya, that enlightenment of Buddha. 3. Sarnath, the first sermon, or Dhammachakraparivartan. 4. Kushinagar, or death, or Mahabhinishkramana. Along with them, Shravati, Shankashya, Rajgir, or Vaishali are known as Ashtamahasthanas. Some of the religious places in Buddhism are Amaravati, Nagarjunakonda, Ajanta Caves, Angkor Wat in Cambodia, Bodhi Tree in Bodhgaya, Borobudur in Indonesia, Bamiyan Caves in Afghanistan, and Ellora Caves. Buddhism is followed by many emperors in the past. Emperor Ashoka Maurya, Kanishka, ruler of Magatha Emperor Bimbisara from India, and countries like Laos, Cambodia, Tibet, Thailand, and some parts of China, Japan, and Malaysia gave royal patronage to Buddhism. With this, we have come to the end of this session on Buddhism. We'll be seeing about Jainism in our next session. Keep following us in YouTube to get regular updates. Hit the subscribe button before you leave the video. Thank you.